I have one treat that I wanted to share with our guests this evening. As you know, we did not do a debate for District 3 commissioner. And at the time, we had a bit of a problem with scheduling. Since that point in time, you know, the two candidates in District 3 are David Hole and Commissioner Todd Levent. Since the original decision not to have a debate, I wasn't really happy with some of the responses I received from one of the candidates in terms of a public statement they made about why we didn't have this debate. And in response to that, I've decided to give their opponent 15 minutes to talk to you guys. So with that, I just want to say one quick thing. It's not an endorsement. It's just giving Commissioner Todd Levent an opportunity to speak to the voters during our debate. I want to be very clear. I'm not endorsing anybody, but I am giving him an opportunity to speak since he didn't have an opportunity to debate. So Commissioner Levent, would you come on up here?
I think we'll turn this around a little bit. I do want to thank you for having the morals and ethics and the foresight to let me speak tonight. In a debate, they typically they let you have an opening speech and a closing speech. And what we'll be missing tonight is the debate between two candidates to let you really see who has the knowledge of surgery. First off, for those of you that don't know who I am, my name is Todd Levent. I am your present District 3 Commissioner. And I would like to thank the Forsyth County Republican Party for their high level of ethics and morals that led to the decision to allow me to speak tonight. It was a little bantering back and forth, and I don't want to get into all that. But unfortunately, two of the dates that they picked were exactly on the commissioner meeting dates. So I don't know if it was intentional or not, but they should have known that it was that night. And then we picked this night, and it's been on my schedule ever since, and I plan to be here no matter what, and here I am. I clearly feel that the public has every right to see their candidates which wish to vote for, and that the transparency is there, and that you have the opportunity to ask us, get to know us, get to see us. After all, I'm here applying for a job, and I'm asking for you to let me serve you for 4 more years. And if I'm not willing to show up for the interview, are you really going to hire me for that job? I've been to a lot of job interviews. I can't imagine me not showing up and still expecting to get the job. I would also like to thank my wife, Dana, my daughter, Alex, and my son, Jared. They have made a lot of sacrifices over the time that I have served. It takes a lot of time to serve the public. I'm very happy to do so, but it also takes some time away from them. And for that, I thank them. Today in Forsyth County, we celebrate a booming economy compared to other counties in the state. When I visit and I take classes around the state through the ACCG and the University of Georgia, you get the opportunity to speak to commissioners in larger counties and in smaller counties. And I will tell you right now that we are the envy of the state. Oh, you're from Forsyth County, you guys have no problem paying your bills. A lot of these counties are struggling. They would, I don't say kill for it, but they really struggle to even get somebody to come in and build a small neighborhood, $100,000 to $150,000 houses. And here we have just the opposite. And it is hard. It's growing pains we all have to deal with. And I think that we have done an excellent job in that. With the county and this heavy growth, our county is extremely financially stable, and we have enjoyed no millage rate increase by the county commissioners, just as I promised the entire time I've been in office. With this growth comes the need for careful planning. The planning needs to be growth that has a positive impact and not a negative impact on all of us. Everybody needs to be kept in mind the best you can. I know whenever there's big growth, it may hurt somebody, it helps others, but you try to find the balance for everybody. This is a positive aspect to everybody. The increase in the school enrollment and traffic that we see today truly has come from zonings that came from the area of 2000 to 2009. Those subdivisions and communities, were half of them were already developed. The other half were already zoned waiting to be developed. The ones that the Board of Commissioners have zoned while I've been on the board today I can't remember one of them that have broken ground. And if they have, they definitely have not built any houses that have produced any children or any cars in the street today. So we have the opportunity for the future to be very careful with the planning of the developments, the price of the homes, that will not be a negative impact on our tax digest, and will be a positive impact on our tax digest. Now that the economy is changing so quickly, and seeing a large increase in application of zoning, it's imperative that the BOC is very careful with the infrastructure, its planning of infrastructure, and all new zonings. This includes feedback from the school board, which I had a nice conversation with my district school board member last night to better understand what they need, what they actually consider overcrowding the schools or not. They're always somewhat over, not kind of what you call them overcrowded, they call it, anyways, the bottom line is always a percentage of students that's over their max, if you will. And they get to a point that you have three high schools that are over 125%, but they require the new school capacity to be at least 80% full. Well, is that 125% really over capacity? Because you take 25% out of each school, that gives you 75%, it still doesn't justify the state and the federal government to give them the money they need for another school. And that's why you see here today, they're asking for bonds to try to stay ahead of this curve, so we're such a fast growing county. As part of the growing pains, we all have to decide, is it worth it or not? All of these things for us to decide, the people. We also asked the state to give us some immediate help with their state roads. They're overcrowded. I get emails all the time. We're doing pretty good with the county roads for the most part. Some of the state roads, when they get overcrowded, it forces people to take the path of least resistance. And you see them taking our county roads, which forces them to overcrowd before their time. Some of the positive planning that comes with the fast growing of the county, and we are the fastest growing county in the state, the seventh in the nation right now. We now have a 30-year water contract in place. We have our latest sewer plant under construction. So our infrastructure planning is going in the right direction. SPLOST projects were voted on by you, the voters. This SPLOST 1 cent sales tax for capital improvements collects anywhere from 2.3 to 2.7 million a month. It's a lot more than most people believe they collect. For the animal shelter, for example, this can be paid out of SPLOST dollars. It takes about 5 or 6 weeks of collection, pays for the entire $3 million project. On the jail courthouse project with the parking decks, it's an estimated $100 million. I'm hoping we're coming under budget. As of right now, we are. It's about a 3-year collection period to have those funds. That, as you know, the animal shelter is well underway and will be opened in July of this year. It's the first county animal shelter ever to be in place. The new jail and courthouse will be done in 12 months, within the next 12 months. Old Atlanta Road has two phases that will start shortly, and Mullinex Road is going to start in the next 6 months for widening. Post Road Library is now open. It was completed with your SPLOST dollars, impact fees, and a $2 million grant from the state. Midway Park has had multiple different facelifts and updatings, and now it'll finally get its upper field, which has never been a regulation field, will now be a regulation field to accommodate more games on Saturday and less arguing over field space. We've even had where they put the cheerleader down the parking lot to do their practicing while the coaches start blocking cars so they didn't get hit. Hopefully that'll no longer be the case. As we plan for the future, and you'd like to see what those future plans are, they're always available on our county website. I know a lot of people like to ask questions on the blogs. It's real simple. You can go right to our county website and find everything you'd like to find. As I served as your county commissioner, I do my best to listen to everybody I can. I know my votes will always not satisfy everybody's wishes. I try my best to get the climate and the environment and serve the mass majority of the people whenever I can. I don't believe that I serve other elected officials. I believe I serve the people. I believe by serving the people, I am fulfilling my oath. With this, I have found myself being endorsed by multiple HOAs, including the president of Polo Fields, the HOA Coalition, Fix Forsyth Track, Fix Citizens for Responsible Growth, and a lot of the activist groups in the community that represent the majority of the people. It was interesting, about 2 years ago, I had a gentleman come up to me and he told me I would never be, he says, Levent, you'll never be reelected. I said, why is that, sir? He says, because you're too honest. I got to tell you, I can live with that all day long. I'm hoping the people realize that I am that honest and I try to have an independent vote. And I hope to show him that he's wrong. With all that said, I humbly ask for your vote May 20th, and please allow me to serve another 4 years. Thank you.